the interesting face-off for me is the two captains, Ravichandran Ashwin, this Virat Kohli. Now, you remember, it's been on Virat Kohli's watch that Ashwin's gone away from white ball cricket completely. You're playing a white ball encounter, two captains against each other. You know, there's going to be a bit of needle there, right?
I'll tell you a very interesting thing. A lot of time this happens. Like, for example, Ashwin, Virat doesn't rate because Virat plays off-spin even with the dusra beautifully. So, for example, Shaurav Ganguly, at that time, there were two of the top bowlers in India was Harbhajan, and of course, Kumble was there and Murali Karthik.
Yeah.
Murali Karthik was a very good bowler, but he was a left-arm bowler and he used to bowl to Shaurav, and Shaurav used to slaughter him. So, you'd never rate him in his head. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, when I'm going out, I don't say, no, that guy is a right-hand batsman, he'll probably struggle against Karthik. Say, Karthik, I hit him for six all the time, you know.
Yeah.
Sometimes in Ashwin's head also, you know, in Virat's head also.
Great, great players should never have a say in selection.
Yeah.
Because they're on a different planet.
True.
Yeah, they're too good and they don't really rate many people.
Yeah.
Because they're that good. They should just play. Dictate when you're out there if you're leading the team. But don't have a say in selection because they will always ear towards what they find difficult, and there's not a lot.
Yeah, that is true.
There's not a lot.
That is true, and which is why sometimes when you say Sachin as a captain, you like he could never understand probably the struggles of regular models because he's just so good.
He used to tell the Mumbai Ranji team that why can't they fire in their throws from 90 yards? And this thing, the Mumbai coach would say, look at their arm, Sachin. Look. They've been malnutrient since they were 7 years old, you know. After eating vada pav, you're not going to throw like you're eating steak. You know?
They did get an egg sponsor though, the Mumbai team. They should have given lots of protein. It's 17 egg whites for you and throw the ball from 90 yards.
The best captains, I always think, are those that have had a kind of career where they've obviously become very good players. You've got to be a good player to be a captain, but you know, you've almost had times where it's not been good for you, and you potentially just had a bit of the bad stuff as well. You've had bad stuff. You've maybe not been the good guy all the time. So you've been able to kind of go across all the different standards of form and also the different standards of what the mentality is that people are in the dressing room. So then you can relate. So if someone's been the naughty kid, you can look and go, come on, in the corner, but I've been there before.
Yeah,
you know, let's have a little chat. You can get out of that. And then there's obviously, if you need to be a good player, the good player in the corner is just going about his business. You've been there and you can go, right, yeah, we know where to take you in this next few weeks. And it's so important, I think, that the leader's just had a little piece of everyone's pie.
Just
so
he knows He knows mortal struggles.
Yes, that's very important. Yeah. When you see someone in the dressing room and you've been there and you've been that person, you're thinking, am I going to get dropped?
Yeah.
Am I going to get dropped this game, next game? I need runs or I need wickets or I need to take that next catch. If you've been in that situation and now you're the leader and you can understand what that person's going through, it's a lot easier to manage them.